and system declared function. What is the function we discuss? System declared function. That is main function. User defined, but system declared function. That is system declared function. I have written this, right? System defined, system declared function, library functions. System defined and system declared. Tell me example. All library functions. Many signaling functions are there. Scanf, printf, all these are library functions. System defined, system declared. User defined but system declared are main function. Again, the third one is user defined and user declared function. User defined and user declared. User declared and user defined. All the user defined functions we will discuss now. User defined, all the user defined functions. We'll define and declare the as a user will it. So three types of functions we classify, right? What is user defined function? What is user defined function? User defined. What is user defined? User can create their own function for performing any specific task of the program. Any, if you want to find the LCM of the particular mathematics problem, you create one particular function for them. So that is user. You can create. User can create their own function and for performing the any specific task of the program. These type of functions are called user defined function. Factorial function you can create, LCM function. Right? Their own any mathematical problem you create as a function. You write the statements for the to execute dot using the syntax. That is called user defined function. You're getting students? I'll use the notes. Don't worry. I'll share today. These types of functions are called user defined. User declares, user defined. Right? Yeah. What are the advantages of using these functions? User functions, user defined functions. What are the advantages? Why we use? Generally, if there is a program, system declared and system defined function, it may be very difficult to understand. Right? Generally, difficult problems are divided into sub problems. It is a big problem. Using the user defined functions, right? Difficult problems is divided into sub problems and solved, and it is easy to dividing the problem, right? This divide and conquer technique is implemented in C through functions. Divide and conquer. ఏదైనా problem ఉందనుకోండి, we can divide and we can share and we can execute that. It's dividing and conquer. That's called divide and conquer. Solutions are merged to get the solution to the original problem. Divide and conquer technique is divide the problem as sub problems or sub sub problems as modules, get the solutions by many of the people are getting solution to individual problems is very easy, sub problems very easy. After merging all the solutions of all the sub problems, we will get the solution of the required problem. This is called divide and conquer technique is implemented in C through using the function, through functions. So the C functions modularizes and divides the work of a program. C functions modularize means it makes as modules. C functions make the given big problem as a modules and divides the work of a program. We're getting students that when some specific code is to be used more than once, second at different places in the program, then the use of the function avoids repetition of that code. Getting a students, same topic manam enna kind of apostrophe la vetam two lines itla two apostrophe itla vetam manam fine ante fine unna same iskoman telusu kada whenever write same your name branch CSC kind of ila vetesam two apostrophe so same like but why you are writing so I am also same CSC department I am sorry EC department you are EC no EC department I am also easy. So that's why you will write same house address. If sometimes same permanent and temporary address, same like you write less like this. Same like here, when some specific code is to be used for more than once particular code to solve the problem, again you want to use the same code. No need to write again at a different places in the program. No need to write every time. Whenever you use the function, then the user function awaits the replication of that code. That's it. Getting this is second advantage. Third one, the program becomes easily understandable. The program becomes easily understandable, modifiable, and easy to debug and test. You write as if you divide as the modules, it is a problem. Easy to get the errors. Right? The program becomes easily understandable, modifiable, and easy to debug and test. Right? And it becomes simple to write the program also. Understand what work is done by each part of the program. We divide as sub problems. Oh, someone has assigned sub problem one, sub problem two. Carefully they will execute that without errors. Then we can identify, okay, what problem in this sub problem one, sub problem two, like that. So easy to understand, simple to write the program, understandable. Understand that work is done by each part of the program. Easy to understand what work is done by each part of the program. That's it, right? That's third. Fourth one, reduction of work and time. Right? Reduction of work and time. If you use the same code again and again, it may help to save the time as well. It work also. The reduction of work and time. Fifth one, functions can be stored in library and right, and reusability can be achieved. I'll show you. Functions can be stored in library. If whenever you want to use again, you can use. Right? Yeah, functions can be considered as black box because arguments will be passed as input and provide result in the form of the return value. It is called. Can be considered as black box because arguments will be placed, right? Arguments will be passed to as input and arguments will be passed as input and provide result in the form of the return value. These are the six advantages if you use the user defined functions, right? Now parts of the function. Which parts it contains? Parts of the function, right? Yeah. Send function declaration or function prototype. First part is function declaration. Student, try to understand very carefully. వినలేదనుకోండి మొత్తం టాపిక్ మొత్తం ఇవన్నీ కూడా మళ్ళీ అన్నిట్లలో వాడతాం మనం రికర్షన్లో వాడతాం ఫంక్షన్స్ పాయింటర్స్లో వాడతాం స్ట్రక్చర్స్లో వాడతాం రైట్ ఫంక్షన్ డిక్లరేషన్ ఆర్ ఫంక్షన్ ప్రోటోటైప్ ఫంక్షన్ డిక్లరేషన్ ఫంక్షన్ ప్రోటోటైప్ declaration just like ordinary variables we declare declaration part is there for ordinary primary variables right function definition declaration second part is in the function definition third one is function call right function declaration or a function it is also called function prototype second part is function definition third one is function call what is function declaration I told you enough. Like variables all functions in a C program must be declared before they are invoked in the ordinary primary variables we declare before they are going to be used right before they are used we declare the variable otherwise you can't understand right like variables, ordinary variables, primary variables, all the functions in a C program must be declared before they are invoked, right? A function declaration consists of four parts. Again, this function declaration consists of four parts. Function declaration prototype consists of four parts. First one is function type. Function type, which type of function that is, or it is also called return type. Function type. Second one, function name. I'll give the syntax for each. Function name. Third one is parameter list. Parameter list. Fourth one is terminating semicolon. Semicolon. That's it. These are the four parts of the function declaration. The general syntax of the function declaration, I will write next in the next page. General declaration. It's very important. Just like declaration of ordinary variables, tell me any one of you, what is the syntax? Primary variables or array, one dimensional array. Syntax, primary variables, data type, space, variable name, semicolon. That's simply declared. Variable, data type, space, variable name, and semicolon. Simply we declare. If you want to assign some value, initialization, that's the initialization of the variable, right? Initialization variable will give. Same like, write the general form of the, general syntax of the function declaration. The general syntax for function declaration. Declaration is, yeah, be careful, this is a syntax, same like primary variables or arrays we declared like this. This is function type instead of data type. Function type, space, function name, this is name of the array, same like, and one more is parameter list. Four parts already, parameter list, semicolon, parameter list, semicolon. This is the syntax, general syntax of the declaration of the function. General syntax of the declaration of the function is, so general syntax, write down, this is function type, space, function name, then the parenthesis, parameter list, and semicolon, terminating semicolon. Whatever I told you, four parts, this is function type, that is return type, function name. This is function name, parameter list, within the parenthesis, terminating semicolon, that's semicolon. This is general syntax of the function declaration. Example. Example. Function is integer type function. Name of the function is sum. You want to get the sum of two variables, int x comma int y. Parameters are two parameters, semicolon. This is the syntax. So you are taking integer type of the function. Sum is the name of the function. Int x, two parameters we are passing. Two parameters we are passing. Int x comma into y, two variables, int x, variables also integer type variables, int x into y, that's it. Parameters, two parameters are passing, right? This is called function prototype. This is called function declaration or function prototype. Function prototype. This is a comment. Comments, one line, single line comment. Back slash star function prototype star slash, that's it. This is single line. When a function does not take any parameters and does not return any value, that's it. Its prototype is written. So not take any parameters, no parameters, no return value, no parameters, any parameters, no parameters, and no return type, return value. What how to declare? No void sum. Again void. We are not passing any parameters. No return value. This is a syntax. Write the void sum void. That's it. Students are getting no parameter list, no return value. This is void sum. We in this previous example, int sum int x into y. So function prototype. We are taking the integer type function. So return function is int and parameters also integer. A prototype declaration may be placed in two places in a program. See, prototype declaration. This is prototype declaration. It is prototype declaration is may be placed in two places. One place declaration may be in two places. The program. First one is above all the function including main. Above all the functions, including main. Right? Or inside a function definition. Are you getting, students? Prototype declaration may be placed in two places in a program. First one is above all the functions, including main function, above main function also. Inside a function definition or inside a function definition. These are the two places. Right? Yeah, what is prototype function is used to inform the compiler of the name, data type, and arguments list, user defined functions. And run the program. That is. See about function declaration. So called prototype, function prototype. Right? When we place the declaration above all the functions, right? That is called the prototype is referred to as a global prototype. The first part. This one. Above all the functions. Function declaration is done in above all the functions. That is called the prototype is referred as a global prototype. Such declarations are available for all the functions in the program. We declare the function above all the functions just before the header files. You declare the function. That function prototype is referred to as the global prototype. Such declarations are available for all the functions. We declare 10 functions also. Those are available for all the functions in the program. When we place the declaration in the function definition, it's called local declaration, right? Then the prototype is called a local prototype. Such declarations are primarily used by the functions containing them. Inside the function definition, if you write, that is only available for only that particular function. We declare the above the all the functions, that is called global prototype. The declarations are available for all the functions in the program. We declare inside the function definition, it's called local prototype. Such declarations are primarily used by the functions containing them. These are the two types, right? So the place of the declaration of a function define a region in the program in which function may be used by the other functions. This region is called the scope of the function. This region is known as the scope of the function. Okay, students. What is global declaration section? Before main, right? Global declaration section. Discuss. This is about the declaration of. This is the function declaration. We discussed about this. The function declaration. What is next? Function declaration. Next one is function definition. Second part is the parts of the function, right? Second part is function definition. Second one is function definition. The function definition consists of the whole description and code of a function. Just we declare, just like declaration of the primary variables, right? Here also we declare the prototype, function prototype, two type. We can it can be placed in two places. I already discussed global declaration, local declaration, but the function definition, right? The function definition consists of the whole description and the code of the function. It tells what the function is doing, what are its input and what are its outputs. Right? Definition and the మొత్తం డిస్క్రిప్షన్ ఉంటుంది. దాంట్లో ఇన్పుట్ ఏం తీసుకుంటాము, అవుట్పుట్ ఏం తీసుకుంటాము, ఎవ్రీథింగ్ విల్ బి ఇన్ ద డెఫినేషన్ ఆఫ్ ద ఫంక్షన్. రైట్? కన్సిస్ట్ ఆఫ్ ద హోల్ డిక్లరేషన్ డిస్క్రిప్షన్ అండ్ కోడ్ ఆఫ్ ఏ ఫంక్షన్. డిక్లేర్ చేసుకుంటాం అక్కడ డిస్క్రిప్షన్. ఫంక్షన్ డెఫినేషన్ ఇస్ కంప్లీట్ బాడీ. వాట్ ఈస్ దట్ డెఫినేషన్? నెక్స్ట్ దిస్ ఫంక్షన్ డెఫినేషన్ టెల్స్ వాట్ ద ఫంక్షన్ ఈస్ డూయింగ్. వాట్ ద ఫంక్షన్ ఈస్ డూయింగ్ అండ్ వాట్ ఆర్ ఇట్స్ ఇన్పుట్స్ అండ్ వాట్ ఆర్ ఇట్స్ అవుట్పుట్స్. Its inputs and outputs. This is in the function definition. Yeah, same like a function definition. Definition consists of two parts. Function definition also consists of two parts. Same like function declaration, four parts. That is return type, the function type, space, function name, and a parameter list in the parentheses and semicolon, four parts. Same like function definition, two parts. First one is a function header and a function body. It consists of function header. Second one is function body. It consists of two parts. Function definition consists of two parts, function header and function body. So what is the general syntax? General syntax of the function definition is, yeah, right, so return type, function name, parameter list. This is header of the function. Return type, function name, parameter list. Same like whatever we declared, same like return type, function name, parameter list, and semicolon. That is a declaration. Here, this part is header file, function header. And you can declare the local variables inside that. Local variable declaration inside the body. Local variable declaration statements and return expression. Return expression semicolon and close it. This is called second part. That's the function body within the floor brackets. This is function body. This is function header. It's completely, this is called the called function. This is called called function. This is called whatever the function definition is called. That is in this. This is function called function. This is called called function. Right, students? It is called called function. Over this Jamboard. Take one more Jamboard. PC. Are you following students?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
అర్థం కాకపోతే అడగండి, ఇమ్మీడియట్ అడగండి. ఎందుకంటే ఈరోజు టాపిక్ స్టార్ట్ చేసినప్పుడు బేసిక్స్ అర్థం కాకపోతే మిగతా అర్థం కాదు, కన్ఫ్యూజ్ అవుతారు. ఇమ్మీడియట్లీ అడగండి, రైట్? ఫంక్షన్ డెఫినేషన్ సింటాక్స్ ఆల్సో ఓవర్, రైట్? దిస్ కాల్డ్ ఫంక్షన్ ఇస్ ఓవర్, రైట్? నెక్స్ట్ ద ఫస్ట్ లైన్ ఇన్ ద ఫంక్షన్ డెఫినేషన్ ఇస్ నౌన్ యాజ్ ఫంక్షన్. ఐ ఆల్రెడీ టోల్డ్ యూ ఆఫ్టర్ ద బాడీ ఆఫ్ ద ఫంక్షన్ ఇస్ రిటర్న్ ఎన్క్లోజ్ విత్ ఇన్ ద curly braces. Example, example of the function definition. Example of function definition. Example of function definition is int. This is function type. Sum. Same example. Sum. Int x, comma int y. Right, this is header of the function. Two parts are there in the function definition. This is header of the function. Now, int s is to calculate the sum, to store the sum. S equals to x plus y. Return s. That's it. This is the body of the function. This is called body of the, this function is called. This is called called function. What is the called function? Sum is the called function. It's called call function. If the function is not returning any value, then void is written at the place of the return type. The type of the return type. This is return type is int here. Return type. If function is not returning any value, then void is written at the place of return type. That's instead of int. Since it does not accept any arguments, so void is written inside parameter. Right. Does not support any parameter list, accept any parameter list, any parameters, then immediately write void here also. Example, same. Void sum, again does not accept any arguments, like it is also void. Then s equals s, sorry, int s, int s s equals to x plus y. That's it. No need to write any return value. No need to write return. That's it. Int s equal to x plus y. Right? This is the second part of function. Function declaration is over. Function definition. This is function definition. Function declaration is over. Function definition. What is third one? Function call. Next one is. Oh, missed it. Whatever function, okay, leave it. Third one is function call. Third part is function call. Right? The function definition describes the what a function can do. Yeah, we discussed the function definition describes what a function can do, but actually use it in the program. Right, the function should be called somewhere. Function definition undi mara function ekkada declare chestam anedi undali kada, function ekkada manam vaadu ekkadiki call chestunnam teliyali kada. Where should be called this function? This is called function. Some more function is called function call or call function, right? This, so the function is called by simply writing its name followed by the argument list inside the parentheses. A function is called, function is called by simply writing, writing is writing its name somewhere, name followed by the arguments are argument list, right? Inside the parentheses. Parentheses. right? You can write a general syntax. What is the syntax of the function call? Function syntax of the function call. Just simply write the function name. Function name. Parenthesis. Argument list. Argument list. Semicolon. This is called calling function. This is called calling function. You are calling just a name, declaring somewhere. It is in the main function or any user defined function. Immediately, if you write this name and argument list and semicolon, immediately control goes to that called function. And where called function is nothing but the it has a description and everything. Right? What are the inputs and what output? The description is there. Everything is there in the called function. Immediately it calls. This is called calling function. This is called calling function. We are calling this. We are calling. Right? This is called calling function. Example. Simply sum. We are passing two arguments. Sum A comma B. If there are no arguments, the function call should have the empty parenthesis like sum. This is no arguments. If no arguments, sum this like this. Simply sum. Calling function. Simply write sum A comma B. Calling function. Just function name. Arguments list in the parenthesis semicolon. This is called calling function. If no arguments, like sum this like. Understood, students? Right. The function name is known as called function. Well, the function in which this function call is placed is known as the calling function. This is the difference between calling function, called function. You should know the difference between called function, calling function. The function name is known as the called function. Well, the function in which this function call is placed is known as calling function. You're getting students differentiate sometimes. Called function, calling function. Clearly told you, this is calling function. Where is the called function? Where the function definition is written, that part body of the header of the body and this definition of the body, that is called called function. Right, students? Right. Right. Function arguments. What are the function arguments? We discuss about calling function, called function, the three parts of the function, one by one, definition, declaration, definition, and function call. Three. Each syntax related. What is function argument? What are the function arguments? Function argument. The calling function ends some values to the called function for communication. Getting or not, students? Calling function. Where it is? We'll mention in the particular. Just today. Calling function. We mentioned calling function just like this syntax. We'll write syntax. Function name and in the parenthesis argument list or parameter list semicolon. The calling function sends some values to the called function for communication. These values are called arguments or parameters. All right. The calling function sends some values to the called function. For communication. Communication. These values are called arguments or parameters. These values are called arguments or parameters. These are called, these values are called arguments are, these arguments are called, these values are called arguments or parameters. Ardham avutha babu students? How many of you joined? Only 41. But I don't know what about others, how they understand the functions. I started basics, right? The calling function sends some values to the called function to communicate, right? These values are called arguments or parameters. So function arguments are classified into two types. There are two types. Arguments are two types. Arguments two types. First one is actual arguments. Actual arguments. Second one is formal arguments. Actual arguments, formal arguments. Right? Actual arguments, formal arguments. What are the actual arguments? First one. What are the actual arguments? The arguments which are mentioned in the function call are known as the actual arguments. The arguments which are mentioned in the function call are known as actual arguments. So, since these are the values which are actually sent to the called function. In the previous example, we have taken. You send the list. Function call lo argument list unda deeni em antunte actual arguments. This is function call. What we are using here as arguments, these are called actual arguments. The arguments which are mentioned in the function call argument list, right? So these values which are actually sent to the called function, we know sum of a comma b, we send this as the actual arguments, right? Actual arguments can be written in the form of variables, right? Variables, constant, expressions, or any function call that returns a value. Actual arguments like one case can be written. Actual arguments can be written in the form of variables, constants, expressions, or any function call that returns a value. Example, like function name is fun, fun, x actual argument, or func is the name of the function. We are passing the, this is variable, x is a variable. We are passing the constant values. We are passing two constant in the function. Func is the function name, and we are passing the two constant, 22 and 40, whatever. Or one more one function. We can pass the expressions also. A into b, can pass c into d plus k, whatever you can pass, etc. We are passing the variables. We are passing the constant values. We are passing the expressions through. These all are actual arguments. We are passing. Right, in the function call, right? Formal arguments. Actual arguments are mentioned in the function call. The formal arguments are the name of the arguments which are mentioned in the function definition are called formal or dummy arguments. Dummy arguments are formal arguments. The name of the arguments which are mentioned in the function definition are called the formal or dummy arguments, right? Yeah, they are used just to hold the values that are sent by the calling function. Temporary names, just temporary, dummy, called for just the formal or dummy or temporary, since they are used just to hold the values that are sent by the calling function. Getting students? The formal arguments are simply like other local variables of the function, which are created when the function call starts and destroyed when the function ends. That's it. These formal arguments are simply like other local variables of the function, which are created when the function call starts and destroyed when the function ends. That's it. These are the formal arguments. Actual arguments, formal arguments. I'll stop here. Next, actual arguments. What is return statement? How to use this return statement? Next, different types of functions we'll discuss. Example programs, the small basic programming programs in the functions I will execute in the next class. Tomorrow you'll have the class. Don't have, I think, right? You don't have, no? Okay, if possible I will take extra class in this weekend for functions. Okay students, enter the attendance in the chat box as well. One more concept is, what is the time now? 12:05. Okay, I don't want to extend this enough. I'll take the attendance. Yes.